Chairman Anglesi.
Thank you, Madam President. Some may not know that actually I have a great ancestor who served on the ships that sailed the Christopher Columbus. This individual wasn't educated, couldn't read or write English. This was fascinating. Spanish or Italian. Would listen to Christopher Columbus on the deck during the voyage and speak in his foreign tongue. At that time was called Latin. Read from a thing he thought was a book, was the Bible. It was a hard situation. Most people who decide to go on this voyage weren't necessarily willing participants. Most of them thought, I'm not going because I think it's the end of the world, it's flat. But you know, Queen Isabella decided, you know what, I need to further explore and expand my empire. So she contacted, and the guy showed up, a guy named Christopher Columbus. He said, can you help me, Queen Isabella? Can you help me fulfill your dream of creating a trade route to China, to the other side? I didn't know it was over there. To fill your dream with increased commerce and growth and prosperity, at least in her mind, for her people and her country. First guy, Christopher Columbus said, yes, I will take that. I will have three ships. The folks on the ship, by the way, just to get a sense, I know we talk about education, as you know, City Province has the worst education, worst school system in the nation right now. But back then, it was even worse. They couldn't read, write. There was no GPS. There was no cell phones. There was no Coast Guard. There was nothing. So some of those folks on that ship, some were willing and some were unwilling. And they weren't, let's just say, the strongest of characters. But they were on a mission for Queen Isabella. Now, just so you understand, my great ancestor wasn't perfect. I recognize that. And in fact, I realized most likely when my cousin died on the shores of Normandy, he wasn't perfect either. But he died for a purpose. When my cousin served in Vietnam as a gunny sergeant, he wasn't perfect. When my brother almost passed away and served in Vietnam, he wasn't perfect. When my father, who served in the Korean War, he wasn't perfect either. But they decided at that moment in time that there was a mission statement, that there was a purpose, that was willing to put your life on the line for, willing to explore for, or to put an idea. So Christopher Columbus sailed blue, you heard it all. But this idea that this one individual on three ships that went that big, probably as big as this room here, all of a sudden created like this unbelievable, horrific event. As I can say, just pretty naive. Now folks, you want to know a horrific event? It's called a Holocaust. An organized, regulated event to kill people. That happened not more than 50, 60 years ago. That was an organization. Christopher Columbus is charged to find another trade route. His job was to find another passage for exploration. I celebrate Christopher Columbus for many reasons. One, of course, because of my own Italian heritage, as well as, by the way, my German heritage. My grandmother came from Germany at the time, which wasn't a very pleasant place, but she had to leave. So, I celebrate the spirit of exploration, the spirit of willing to take a chance, or the willingness to make a better life. Now, to put the blame on this individual, it seems to be extremely, how do I put it, obtuse. It's a way to make a political point or a political statement about someone that something happened in 1492 when we all learned. It's pretty silly. What we should be thinking about is that in some parts, in some ways, as Councilman Taylor just mentioned about the Dominican Republic, he's absolutely right. You know, they celebrate the exploration, the identification, and the problem. And I know there's a strong connection between the time and the Dominican Republic because of that. And by the way, I'm proud of that. Not only am I proud of that, but I'm sure proud of the fact that, at least today, I can say I have brothers and sisters on an island in the Dominican Republic. I have brothers and sisters across the world. It's not perfect. But I think we need to celebrate the spirit of exploration, the spirit of willingness to take a chance, and to make a better life. If it's as simple as this devaluing of everybody's effort, because it was a monstrous effort, it's kind of, a very basic application of just trying to promote a political agenda in order to devalue the spirit of exploration and devalue the positive aspect of what happened to it. So, I don't condone any negative events because some of those folks on that ship, they weren't perfect. Some of those folks on the island were bad perfect. Last time I checked, and last time I checked, I'm not perfect. So, I want to thank Christopher Columbus, and I want to thank the Dominican Republic, I want to thank my Cosmopolitan. I think we should celebrate this event, just like we celebrate other. By the way, individuals in American, in European, in world history that weren't perfect, but at least acknowledge the positive aspects of it. And it's something, I think that's part of what we should do. You know, as you say, you know, forgiveness, a sense of mercy, a sense of a willingness to see the better half, the better aspects of people. The glass is half full, not half empty. So I recognize and I acknowledge Councilman Taylor's statement because he's now talking about another piece, not just the history of Christopher Columbus, but the history of his neighborhood. It's rich, it's loving, it's not perfect, folks, but you know what? It's something that he's proud of and the people that live there are. So I think we should just